Sriracha chili sauce has become the must-have condiment for those millions of people out there who are willing to make a trade-off between a scorched tongue and the sauce's unique, spicy, garlicky flavor. Everyone who's tried it knows that it's good on everything, and by everything, we literally mean everything. But what is it about this sauce that gives it its spicy kick? The basic ingredients of sriracha are fresh ground red chilies, vinegar, garlic, salt, and sugar. Now, inside those red chilies is a group of molecules called capsaicinoids. Within this group, two molecules pack up to 95% of the blistering punch, capsaicin and dihydrocapsaicin. These two molecules trigger the TRPV1 receptor protein in our mouths, which usually responds to scalding temperatures above 109 degrees Fahrenheit, thus causing the spicy hot sensation. Then, the body responds to capsaicin's burn by releasing a pain-killing endorphin rush, kind of like the one a jogger feels after a long run. Capsaicin is naturally found in the plant genus Capsicum, which is fancy science Latin for peppers. Bell, Aleppo, Habanero, Tabasco, Cayenne, Poblano, Serrano, you name it, they're all in the capsicum genus. And although these peppers are closely related, there's a big difference between the heat of each of these peppers. So how can we use science to measure which pepper is more spicy than another? In 1912, a clever pharmacist named Wilbur Scoville devised a heat measurement scale less cleverly named the Scoville scale. This scale ranges from 0 Scoville heat units all the way up to 16 million, which is the endpoint for pure capsaicin. Basically, Scoville would extract the capsaicin out of pepper and dilute it with a solution of sugar and water until the heat was undetectable by a taste tester. Every additional dilution increases the scale. So for example, a bell pepper at 0 would not be diluted at all, while a jalapeno pepper that rests around 4,000 Scoville count would be diluted 4,000 times. This measurement scale has been criticized due to the subjective perspective of taste testers, and more modern approaches of measurement have been devised. High-performance liquid chromatography is a method of accurately measuring the concentration of capsaicinoids in a pepper. This form of spice measurement doesn't use Scoville units, but instead American Spice Trade Association Pungency Unit. One pungency unit is equal to about 1/15th of a Scoville unit, and are actually a parts per million count of capsaicin in a particular pepper. So then, where does sriracha fall on the Scoville scale? Depending on the crop of peppers used, sriracha can range from 1,000 to 2,500 Scoville units. To put that into perspective, Tabasco sauce runs anywhere between 2,500 and 5,000, while Texas Pete hot sauce is around 750, and a habanero pepper contains upwards to 350,000. Now that's a lot of capsaicin. Sriracha also contains two extra compounds, potassium sorbate and sodium bisulfite, that help maintain its long shelf life and vibrant red color. Potassium sorbate inhibits the growth of molds and yeast in the product and is found in other foods such as dairy products, wine, dried fruits, and meats and juices. Sodium bisulfite, on the other hand, stops the natural browning reaction that occurs when fresh produce is oxidized, giving each bottle of sriracha that lasting, highly distinguished red color. Three ingredients that greatly add to sriracha's flavor, salt, garlic, and vinegar, also act as a natural antimicrobial preservative that keep the bottle long-lasting even without refrigeration. Now this is a really great fact to know, but it's pretty much useless because as far as we understand, it's impossible for a bottle of sriracha to go bad without having eaten it all because again, it goes good on absolutely everything.